What's going on, Hockey Nation? My name is Nikita, and this is the Hockey Nation for all hockey fans like you. Make sure to give me a like and subscribe in this video before you leave it. And I wanted to talk about Slava Voynov. Obviously, a very messed up situation there between him and his wife. Obviously, they went to court a couple of days ago. The arbitrator ruled that Voynov will only miss half of next season, so he's eligible after the 41st game played. And obviously, a lot of people have a problem with that because they knew that he went through a lot of bad things with his wife. First off, you know, she was beat pretty much to blood, pretty much to death. And that's what's been reported. Now, I'm not sure of the situation, how it went down. I wasn't there at the time, so I can't really speak for the situation. And I know that it sounds very stupid and very bad. And I know what you guys are thinking right now, like, this guy should have been suspended a lot more. But if you take a look at the timeline, he's been suspended since 2014 from the NHL. So he really hasn't been able to get to play in competitive leagues. I mean, I guess KHL is a competitive league, but again, he only played there for, I think, two seasons. Got the Gagarin Cup, which is pretty much like a Stanley Cup in the NHL, but man, it's not the same competition. Obviously, he was a very good top four defenseman during his time in the NHL. I would love to see him back in either LA or somewhere else. Apparently, LA and their Twitter account already tweeted out saying that he's not going to come back and play for LA anymore. So obviously, we know that he's going to become a free agent, I believe, this summer, because his rights end with LA this summer. So should be interesting to see who he signs with and who approaches him. I've heard a team like Montreal in the past who's going to go out there and try to pursue him, and I don't see the reason why they wouldn't. I mean, they obviously need some D. They would like to use some puck-moving defensemen on that blue line. Obviously, the guys Shea Weber and Jeff Petrie, who are pretty good offensive defensemen. They're also pretty good in their D zone as well, and that's what Voynov is. So if they have three strong right-handed defensemen, then that makes for a good top six D core there. And I know I'm speaking a little bit under pressure, but I'm currently on my bike, so I didn't have any other time to really record about this and talk about it, so I decided to talk about it now. And I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Make sure to let me know your thoughts down in the comment section. And as always, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe if you're new and passing by. And if you're a hockey fan like me, don't forget to hit that bell button so you don't miss any of your future videos on this channel. And my name is Nikita, and this is the Hockey Nation. Catch you guys real soon.